His death was as good a death as any might hope, asleep in the arms of one beloved. Harold was born on February 23rd, 1932, in Braxton County, West Virginia, the eighth of 10 children to Bernard and Effie Layton. He is survived by two younger siblings, Kenneth Layfield and Olga Jean Barber. The love of his life and lifelong companion, Leona Mae Ham, they were blessed with three children, Stephen Michael, Mike Layfield, William Harold, Bill Layfield, and Tina Michelle Layfield Helms. They were blessed with the love of three grandchildren, Gabriel Collins Fonsler, Leah Nicole Hebert, John Harold Helms, and two great-grandchildren, Luke David Hedrick and Leona Luna Sponsor. The burial will take place here at the Crown Hill Burial Park. Harold had a special request as part of this service. He described his own legacy as a regular country boy, a humble man who tried his best. He was that, and so much more. I'll share more about this remarkable man in a moment, but at Harold's request, Amazing Grace. Here is Alan Jackson.
Thank you.
A song that has stood the test of time, much like the man we remember today. I'm reading from John chapter 14, verse 14. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you. I'm going to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. You know where I'm going, and you know the way. Please join me. Heavenly Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for your comfort, your protection, and the grace you provided for each of us. You've truly prepared a place for us beyond this life. I trust we will all meet you there some glad morning, but in this day we are a hurting people. But you are a God that understands our pain, our loss, the ache in our hearts. I ask that your Holy Spirit be welcomed in this place. We need you. Amen. I'm Mark Beale. Harold Lightfield was my uncle, and it's an honor to share his story. It's a life well lived. The testament of a man, as I noted a few moments ago, who was a regular country boy. But as I stand here today, I can assure you, he was so much more. Harold was blessed to be part of a large family, the kind of family whose hearts were as big as the West Virginia hills they called home. There were an even dozen in the family of Bernard and Effie Layfield, all striking in their good looks, all singularly devoted to one another, to family, to love, to laughter, to times around the porch, or in the campfire in the summer. Walking together, brother and sister, to the one-room schoolhouse, living their best life. Later in life, this remarkable family, called Layfield, would create occasion after occasion, event after event. The outward purpose of a reunion or a trip, putting up hay, a trip to a cabin in Pennsylvania, all that wasn't important. Spending time together, that was supremely important. The strong bond of family began at a young age. This wasn't city life with a lot of neighborhood kids. More often than not, all they had were each other, and that was just fine. If you watched Mike's interview with his dad, you know there's such a thing as bushwhacking. They had a grove of slender Hector trees. The boys would climb those trees, get them swinging from one to another, then